Yolanda King, that was the first daughter. There used to be an amusement park that was down on Highway 75, and which was the old way, where it used to be to the airport, and they passed it all the time, and it was called Fun Town. And Yolanda said to her dad that when you come back next week, will you take me to Fun Town? And he kind of said, well, you know, we'll talk about it. Well, what he knew that Yolanda did not know is that she could not go to Fun Town because she was black. And so here she'd been seeing her dad fight injustice all the time and trying to make life better. And she didn't understand all of the injustices. And so finally the weekend came and he had come back on a trip and she said, Daddy, don't forget, we're going to Fun Town on Saturday. And he said, he finally had to sit her down and said one of the most painful moments of his entire life was to tell his daughter that she could not go and play at this amusement park, the mere fact that she was black. Here's a kid who went to Sunday school all the time, listened to what you teach about having self-respect, having, you know, the love of God, and God created each of us in his own image. You know, we say that, and then she's got to wonder, well, how did this happen? I can't go because of the color of my skin. And he said, and even in his later life, he said that that would remain as one of the hardest jobs he ever had, was to tell her she couldn't go because she was black.
And he said, I'm not going to stop until we figure out how we can solve that Fun Town problem.
Right.
And of course it did. But
I was telling that story because one of the girls was kind of fascinated with that, knew Martin Luther King personally.
Probably bossed him around the time,
yeah,
too.
Right, yeah.
Put him in the same.